If you're ready for the next interview, let me hear you say hell yeah. Stage. It's one of my player partners, man. He's been doing it for a long time, and he's blowing up right now. You've seen him in all these videos, BET, MTV, motherfucking Soundstage. You've seen him on VH1. He's currently on the VH1 show right now. One of the number one teasers in the game. Y'all start giving up. Give it up, give it up, give it up, give it up for my homeboy, Greg! Hey, yo, bro, you done turned into a superstar since the last time I seen you, bro.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, man, you gonna love the hip-hop, man, shit.
Yeah, man, I like being on TV, shit.
How you feel about it, man? What's the difference?
Difference is 5 million viewers every week.
Yeah. Come on, man. Yeah. Yo, Captain, we need it now. We need it in our life. This my new main chick right here.
I see.
It happens.
You gotta remember, I'm like more underground from the street, so when they put this kind of hip-hop on VH1, number one, I commend them for putting this type of hip hop on TV. Number two, I just like being on TV, motherfucker.
It's right.
I like being a lot.
Yeah, I'm
gonna
say, cause you're like really nasty lyrically.
Yes.
Like you're hardcore and like a lot.
Nasty.
Like literally nasty, yeah.
What does that mean?
It means he's coming for people like all the time. Like I feel like you're ready for war when you rap it. So, like,
you know he came after 50 Cent one time, right?
We ain't gonna talk about that. I'm not sure.
Oh,
I fuck with 50 Cent.
I'm in a recent interview with DJ Thorough, I think, on this thing. You said, listen to me.
I'm listening.
You better. You said that you, if there was a movie, if they can make a movie about your life, that it would be called The Rise of the Underdog. So, if you feel you're the underdog, who's the top dog to you right now? Because that would be your competitor. Like, who do you feel would compete with you right now? Because you're very competitive.
I'm very competitive by nature. Competition-wise, I don't feel like nobody can compete with me. That's just my... That's how I... Not even
Drake, nobody, none of them. Because, I mean,
Drake
actually looks up to you.
Drake. I salute Drake. I look up to his music as well. But, lyrically and competition-wise, if you're not playing to be a best, then don't play. What's up, though?
Hey, how you doing? I'm Alan Bree.
Hey.
I'm Alan Bree.
My question to you.
What's up?
How did you feel when my DC mother came in and you told me to tell you about?
Shit, I didn't know what she was doing. I was like, I can't body slam nobody's grandma. What I look like?
Yeah, you was being hard on her too.
That happened to me before.
He ain't have no remorse.
I ain't know what to do. I'm like, yo,
I can't
be with my grandma. I'm a gentleman. You will never see me on TV or any platform arguing with a woman, especially not somebody's mother. Like, that'll never happen. I don't care what the issue is. I'm a real
nigga.
Let me tell you something, bro.
Yeah.
When I had first started going through things, like when my relationship was on the outs,
I went to my lady grandma's house, right? And when I walked through the door, she said, "What the fuck you doing here? You wasn't invited, motherfucker. Herman, say what you got to say to her and get the fuck out my house."
Damn.
I was like, what? I was about to cuss this bitch.
You can't. That's like cursing at God.
I remember interviewing you like back in the day.
Oh shit. Okay.
721, you know, yeah. Production. You were with Black Hand back then.
Yeah, those are all shout out to you.
Yeah, so I mean, I wanted to know, like, when I saw when I saw you on Love and Hip Hop, I was like, wow, this is really big for grab. But I actually saw the photo shoot before you did Love and Hip Hop, and I was like, oh, Grass is looking all right.
What's up, Versace on and on?
But, you know, so I saw you kind of glowing up and stuff like that, and you still look good.
Not glowing up.
Okay.
He was glowing up.
See, all you did, you point the thing. But is that the first time, is Yandy the first one that kind of got you into yourself, like motioning your elbows and all that good stuff?
I mean, my shit lotion now.
No, you got a name drop for us, Dow.
I can. I like Ghost Rider. You
have a clothing line, you said.
I do, yeah. I got a clothing line called Lil Payne.
Why the fuck you bring me no shit?
I have no more shit right now.
Do you sell that shit for big niggas?
When you get on TV and start selling shit, it goes.
That's why I gotta keep that supply coming in. I need me a shirt.
That's why I like the TV shit. The bag is going. Tracked her down in the beginning. When I saw her doing business, like, yo, she's got her business. Let me try to see stuff. And, you know, I met her and broke out. I made a couple dollars together. Well, I believe it don't stop.
Let me hold your mic real.
Hey, you ever tried to hit your hand? Like,
no, I did. Go ahead. I knew she was on the show.
Oh, Lord. Any other questions?
I wasn't scared of Buddy. He was in jail. He ain't on it for 8 years. Man, you got 8 years.
We got them.
They not really married. But they do really got kids, though.
Yeah,
they're gonna still be the same. Okay. You know what I mean?
Let me tell you.
Business and pleasure do never mix. Ever, ever, ever in life. I would never try to make a move with somebody I make money with. Especially if you're in an end position where you might have to touch some money before me.
But what if she said, "Hey, bro, hey, look here. This ain't got nothing to do with business. I just want to suck your dick. What's going on?"
No comment. That's not gonna happen.
If y'all ready for the next interview, let me hear you say hell yeah. The game, they like Batman and Robin, man. They like Tom and Jerry, man. They like Curious George and the Man with the Yellow Hat. But tonight, they gonna do their own thing and they gonna do their thing together. Y'all give it up for
the infamous from Love and Hip Hop, but they doing their own thing. Cause it takes two to make a thing go right. Give it up for BBO, motherfucker. Asians, pull up, let's go.
We gonna need all bad bitches to step in the front with us.
Yes.
Cause we get to this motherfucking money.
Come on.
You know.
You're like, you're getting emotional.
No! Never that!
No emotion. Matter of fact, oh, yeah. Back to the angel.
I have a question, Kat. I'm going to save you.
Save me.
I mean, you guys are really... BBOP came here and you guys are great and awesome. You guys look sexy. And congratulations on your new relationship. But any other endeavors? Because sometimes you know you hear a lot of artists saying we don't get our real money from hip-hop or the music sometimes. It's always like another avenue or another hustle. Are you guys into anything else other than music?
Yeah, that's a fact. As far as the music, it's not consistent, you know what I'm saying? So you have to still grind towards whatever else you want to do until the music picks up to the level that you want it to pick up on.
Yeah,
and
y'all
sell
dope.
Yeah.
And, I don't sell dope, Jack. But I move cars like weight. So anybody want a car, you can holler at me. Bad credit, good credit, no credit, I get you double bill.
It's me again, baddies. I mean, this is a question. I know y'all not dating.
I know y'all got some more famous shit to do. Yo, can you tell us what's to come for BBOD? Because y'all coming back to us in a couple months, right? Because we got a TV show.
Excuse me.
I'm trying
to save you. So right now I got on my new single. It's called Trap House. Y'all can check it out. It's on SoundCloud. And when I shoot the video and drop the video, it's going to be available on iTunes, Spotify. Mo has her new single. I thought it was called Never Scared.
It's called Not Scared.
Not Scared. December 12th.
December 12th. It's also going to be available for pre-order on December the 8th on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play. It's going to be on the Spotify playlist, the iTunes playlist. So just stay tuned. We working.
Yes, sir.